may be asking yourself, who's that incredibly dashing man? The name's Scarfile, Rod Chester Scarfile. Let me tell you something, I'm right where I want to be. Now I know what you're thinking. Rochester, you're stuck to a chair, you've been captured. How in the world are you right where you want to be?
Hey, check this out.
Can you not see I'm about to explain the entire backstory to the situation? Are you no fan of good storytelling, sir? I'll answer the question for you. No, you're not. Now let me get back to it. As I was saying, it was like any other class. I was hard at work, administering the exam.
All done, Mr. Scarfile, sir.
That's Steven Johnson. We'll get back to him later.
You feel confident, kid?
Oh, yes. I think I did really well.
F.
Golly, gee whiz, Mr. Scarfile, you barely looked at it.
Look, I've looked at every exam of every student I've ever had. I know who's gonna get it right and who's gonna get it wrong. You either got it or you don't. You're gonna have to get used to failing, kid. It's part of life.
Well, couldn't you at least check the answer key to make sure?
Fine, kid, it's your funeral.
It was in that moment I knew I was in trouble.
Everyone out!
Is everything all right, Mr. Scarfile?
Get out, kid.
Okie dokie, Mr. Scarfile, sir. Just let me know about that grade when you can.
There was only one man I knew to turn to in my time of crisis.
Hello?
Hello, Professor.
Who is this?
Scarfile. Rochester Scarfile. We have a major...
Didn't I tell you never to call me this?
Professor, I don't know who may be listening in on us, but something terrible has happened. The answer keys for the exams have gone missing.
You lost them, you find them, Rod.
Rochester.
The next exam is in 2 days. If they're not back by then, you're fired.
I was terrified. Like a little hamster, he stopped running along his wheel, hanging on for dear life as he circled round and round.
I will get it done, Professor. You can count on it.
If you'd like to make a call, please hang up and try again.
Dang nabbit. It was late. A quarter after 9:30. That's when I saw her. She was like a gazelle in the Amazon forest. Majestic and graceful, but out of place.
You're beautiful.
You're forward.
What are you doing there?
It's ballet.
Mind if I join you?
I'd rather you not.
I learned as an early lad never to take a rejection at face value, so I joined her.
What's your name?
Scarfile. Rochester Scarfile.
Do you always introduce yourself like that?
Do you always practice ballet on the street in the middle of the night?
Touché. What do you do?
I'm a TA.
A TA for what?
CHM 1025. Intro to Chemistry. One of the damn most important jobs in the land.
I have a friend in your class, Rochester.
A lucky lad.
He says your grading is ruthless.
The class isn't impossible. There is a student passing.
A?
Yes. That's what I said, was it not?
My ring. I've lost my ring. Can you help me find it? Check in those bushes over there.
I don't see it.
And just like that, she was gone. Nothing but wind and memories remained. I had no idea where to start. There were no clues, no sources, nothing. Then suddenly, it hit me. In the moment it made sense that the villainous fiend would be doing poorly in my class, so I decided to cross-reference all the grades with the students. It didn't lead anywhere. But then it hit me. There's always an outlier. It was late, maybe a couple hours before 11:15. It was a crisp 78 degrees. I was sweating profusely underneath my fashionable trench coat. That was when he appeared.
Scarfile.
Carl?
What do you need?
Well, the exam answer keys have been stolen.
Stolen? Is that gonna affect my grade?
God, no. Carl, think about someone else for a change. You're such a teacher's pet.
Well, then what do you need?
I need answers, information, any leads you got. You're on the front lines of every class. What do you see?
Well, what's in it for me?
I knew that little selfish pig would ask that, so I came prepared.
That's been off the market for quite a while. I thought that was against the rules.
Every once in a while, you gotta bend the rules to do what's right.
Very honorable, Scarfile. Stephen Johnson's the name. I heard he needs to really pass that next exam to make it into his music program.
I wasn't going to lie. I was a little confused. I'm a little confused. Why does the music chem major need this chemistry class for his music program?
Look, I supplied the information. Now pay up.
You are some of the filthiest scum on earth, Carl.
Damn straight.
I was lost. I knew that Stephen kid couldn't be the culprit. He was like a happy little duckling splashing in a puddle, just happy for the golden sunshine on a Sunday afternoon. Too innocent.
You're back.
I was hoping I'd see you here again.
It's your lucky night.
If only.
Chemistry a bit too much to bear?
Actually, yes.
What's going on?
I lost it. I lost the exam key. What's your name? I didn't catch it.
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, I don't know what to do. I cross-referenced the grades, interrogated the teacher's pet, and that led me to the Stephen kid, but now I'm not so sure. If I don't find that exam key by the time the exam begins, I'm out.
Rochester. Kiss me.
That's it. What were you expecting? Next thing I know, I'm sitting here talking to you. But like I said, I'm right where I want to be, because I had absolutely no leads in this case. If I wasn't here right now, I'd already have lost my job. So no complaints from this guy.
Can I put the cloth back in your mouth?
Go for it, buddy.
How's it going, Mr. Scarfile? I can't understand you. You seem to have a little cloth in your throat. But I must say, I'm sorry to see you like this. I feel like as your little private eye, I've let you down. But I've got some important stuff to take care of. I gotta get this answer key out to the masses. I'll see you later, Mr. Scarfile. Jazz hands. Oh, can't have jazz hands without a jazz square, can we? Is he going for four? I think he is. I'll see you, Mr. Scarfile. going shopping. Get in. Now, we have to leave you there. Bye!
Sir, I need you to untie me.
What are you doing to my car?
Look, I see it's a very nice, ugly car, but there's no time to argue about this rolling pile of trash. Please, untie me. Thank you. Name Scarfile. Rochester Scarfile. For your time.
Singing in the rain. It's Mr. Scarfile. How about that?
What's going on?
It's so good to see you again, Mr. Scarfile. I was honestly a little concerned you were going to be stuck there for quite some time.
Well, I wasn't, so let go of me.
Okay. Hey, so I gotta upload this key to the internet, but maybe afterwards we could grab lunch or something.
Steven, give me the answer key.
Okay, if you say so.
Do not give him that answer key.
Elizabeth, that's the answer key. Give it to me. I need to get it to the professor.
Sorry, I can't let you do that.
What do you mean?
Do you really think Steven would steal the answer key? He's too good of a guy to go through with it on his own. I did it, Rod.
Rochester. But why?
If Steven doesn't pass this exam, then he can't go to the music program with me. And I can't let you get in the way of that.
Okay, I'm starting to get the vibe that maybe there's something between you two. But I thought maybe me and you?
You're a moron.
Oh my gosh, look over there.
I'm not falling for that.
I don't see anything, Mr. Scarfile.
Yeah, you're right.
What is he doing? What is this?
I don't know, but I like it. Bye, Mr. Scarfile.
It's been a week since the big scuffle that went down. I got the key back to the professor, kept my job, got the love of my life suspended for violating the academic integrity code, and learned a few things along the way.
Still a pitiful little child. F.